I will do an introduction in Spanish. Buenas tardes a todos. Good evening, everyone. Hoy nos reunimos para conocer sobre la trayectoria de la Unión Internacional para la Investigación Cuaternaria y obtener información sobre el programa de becas para movilidad internacional que INCUA ofrece. Van a haber dos charlas de la mano de la doctora Estela Moreiras y del doctor Thijs van Colschoten. Y luego pasaremos a la sección de preguntas. Es un placer para mí introducir a la doctora Estela Moreiras. Moreiras es doctora en ciencias geológicas, es una destacada investigadora cuyo campo de investigación incluye la estratigrafía cuaternaria, los peligros naturales, los deslizamientos de tierra, la neotectónica, la paleosismología, las inundaciones catastróficas de lagos represados por glaciares y deslizamientos de tierra y los cambios ambientales recientes. Ella es investigadora principal de CONICET, profesora adjunto de la Universidad Nacional de Cuyo, miembro del Instituto de Estudios del Ambiente y Recursos Naturales, miembro representante del IANIGLA, que es el Instituto Argentino de Nivología, Glaciología y Ambientes, perdón, y Ambientales, en la Agencia de Ordenamiento Territorial, integrante de Comisión de la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario y Geomorfología, la AACG. Y representante argentina de INCUA. Hoy nos va a contar sobre la trayectoria de INCUA en Argentina. Bienvenida, doctora Estela Moreiras.
Hola, gracias Macarena. Bueno, voy a ver si puedo compartir pantalla esta vez de manera exitosa. Ahí está. ¿Se ve bien?
Perfecto.
Bueno. La idea de esta charla, como bien dijo Macarena, es poner en contexto un poco las actividades que se han estado desarrollando desde Argentina para INCUA. Y para eso voy a primero presentar qué es el INCUA, que en inglés sería International Union for Quaternary Research. Esto es una comisión internacional para el estudio del cuaternario que viene promoviendo los estudios en el cuaternario desde 1928. El INCUA representa casi todos los investigadores, están en INCUA, participan más de 5.000 investigadores alrededor del mundo estudiando las ciencias del cuaternario. Y el mayor esfuerzo de INCUA está puesto en involucrar a aquellos países con menor desarrollo y a aquellos profesionales en sus primeras etapas o los primeros pasos en la carrera de investigación para poder acceder a la investigación de calidad y a la ciencia relacionada al cuaternario. INCUA tiene en sus bases operativas también una postura de operar bajo la filosofía de la inclusión, sin discriminación hacia ninguna religión, ningún género ni orientación sexual. Por lo tal, todos sus proyectos, estos los deja en claro y respeta para los proyectos y los grupos de trabajo que involucran dentro de INCUA. INCUA está manejado o es dirigido
Estela,
por un... Sí.
se ve solo la primera diapositiva. No sé si estás
Ah.
moviéndola, si estás pasando a la siguiente o.
Sí.
Ah,
¿Pasé ahí se movió o no?
ahora estás vos en la pantalla.
Yo tengo en la pantalla bien, pero debe ser el problema de cómo se compartió.
Ah.
A ver. ¿Ahí?
Ahí sí se movió. Quizás también podés ampliar para poner en pantalla
Sí,
completa para que
perfecto.
veamos
Sí,
mejor.
pero ahí está.
Ahí está
Esto lo...
perfecto.
Perdón, gracias
Gracias.
por avisar e
Disculpa,
interrumpir. No, 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 no. Bueno, un poco que les explicaba la postura de INCUA hacia el criterio que tiene para fomentar las investigaciones del cuaternario alrededor del mundo. Y como les decía, hay unos 5.000 investigadores asociados a INCWAD de una u otra manera. Bueno, el INCWA está regido o manejado por un comité ejecutivo en donde tiene un presidente, en este caso Laura Sado, una secretaria que está presente, Aritina, una secretaria general, un tesorero, tres vicepresidentes y Teis, que hoy día nos va a hablar, que es el pasado reciente presidente de INCWA. Este comité generalmente dura 4 años entre cada uno de los congresos que se hacen de INCWA, y este comité informa al Consejo Internacional de Cuaternario sobre todas las actividades y todos los proyectos que se están corriendo, y sobre todo informa de cómo se gastó el dinero. En este Consejo Internacional participan alrededor de 53 países. Muchas veces tienen representante cada país, o también hay representantes que involucran o representan a más de un país. Estos representantes por países tienen que pagar una cuota y el pago de esta cuota, que actualmente es 800 euros, les permite tener voz y voto al momento de planificar las actividades o las acciones que va a priorizar INCWA para los siguientes 4 años. Generalmente esas reuniones del Consejo Internacional se desarrollan en los propios congresos INCWA y de ahí se sientan las bases para las futuras acciones a los próximos 4 años. El año pasado fue el INCWA en Roma y justamente en el Comité Ejecutivo y en el Consejo Internacional, una de las visiones que tuvieron eran de generar estas becas, las becas para investigadores jóvenes o investigadores de países en desarrollo, que es lo que va a presentar TEIS hoy día. Argentina actualmente tiene representante. Yo estoy como representante de la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario y Geomorfología, pero en el caso nuestro no estamos pagando la cuota. Hace varios años que no logramos juntar el monto de esta cuota y por lo tanto participamos en el Consejo Internacional, pero no tenemos voz y voto para decidir qué es lo que se va a hacer los siguientes 4 años. Sí podemos comentar y podemos dar ideas, sugerir, pero no tenemos derecho a voto al momento de votar estas acciones. Bueno, el INCWA tiene distintas ventanas o distintos mecanismos para poder colaborar, a poder trabajar dentro de INCWA. Una de las primeras ventanas es, ay, perdón. Una de las primeras ventanas son los proyectos o las comisiones. Cada una de estas comisiones tienen un perfil principalmente en función del título que dicen, las temáticas que tratan. Hay muchos argentinos, por ejemplo, involucrados en PALCOM, hay otros investigadores que son parte de SACOM y yo he estado más involucrada en TERPRO. Y dentro de estas comisiones pueden haber tanto como reuniones parciales, que son propuestas y financiadas por INCWA, como cursos o congresos incluso o sesiones dentro de los congresos INCWA. También un apartado importante es para los investigadores jóvenes. Tienen digamos, una reunión y unas comisiones totalmente paralelas, distintas a las comisiones ya conformadas dentro de INCWA, con lo cual hay mucho más disponibilidad de proyectos y de becas. Hay un apartado, si entran a la página de INCWA, que trata solo de becas y premios a los cuales pueden postular. En estas becas y premios generalmente tienen mayor prioridad los países que pagan la cuota full. Sin embargo, Argentina ha sido muy beneficiada con becas, tanto para los congresos como para las reuniones. Siempre hay investigadores jóvenes que han podido obtener becas dentro de INCUA. Y de hecho se ha financiado el año pasado para participar en la reunión de Roma. Hubieron más de 20 becas que se les otorgaron a los argentinos para participar de la reunión. En otra parte están los eventos y las reuniones a las cuales pueden ser organizadas por INCUA o que INCUA promociona porque piensa que está dentro de los intereses o las temáticas que aborda INCUA. Por ejemplo, dentro de estas reuniones o cursos, el año pasado se dictó un curso de paleopedología que fue gratuito. Entonces hay muchísimas posibilidades también de conectar gente en diferentes temáticas y también capacitarse. Entonces, esto es una ventana muy importante de actividades que realiza INCUA. Y finalmente, INCUA también tiene una revista que es editada por INCUA y los revisores pertenecen a INCUA, que es Cuaterna International, y han habido una serie de números que justamente han sido promocionados por investigadores argentinos o han sido liderados por investigadores argentinos. INCUA aproximadamente financia unos 130.000 € por año en diferentes tipos de proyectos, ya sean que los proyectos salgan de las distintas comisiones ya incluidas en el INCUA o distintos grupos de trabajo. O sea, hay maneras o llamados para postular a pequeños proyectos o proyectos dentro de las grandes comisiones. Bueno, no voy a hacer mucho hincapié en los estudios que se han realizado dentro del cuaternario en Argentina, pero bueno, Argentina tiene una trayectoria bastante importante en estudios del cuaternario, ya desde Charles Darwin en 1842, pero la visión del cuaternario, digamos, para hacer una asociación o un grupo de investigadores, nace en 1981 con un congreso geológico en San Luis, en donde se propone hacer o congregar todos los investigadores que están analizando el cuaternario en Argentina en una asociación que se denominó Amigos del Cuaternario. Y bajo esta figura se hicieron distintas reuniones en 1986 en Mar del Plata, en 1987 en Río Cuarto y en 1988 en Paraná. Ahí recién surge, o en paralelo, surge una visión de congregar todos los investigadores que estuvieran trabajando en Cuaternario de Argentina en un comité al cual denominaron CADINCUA. Y este comité CADINCUA respondía estrechamente a INCUA. Esta asociación inicialmente, el CADINCUA, era financiada por CONICET. Entonces era CONICET quien daba el subsidio para pagar la cuota internacional dentro de INCUA. En 1986, Martín Iriondo fue seleccionado o elegido como presidente del CADINCUA, y generalmente el presidente de CADINCUA era el que, digamos, era el investigador visible ante INCUA. Así, a partir de ese hito, digamos, empezaron a involucrarse más Argentina en INCUA a través de distintos simposios, como por ejemplo el simposio del Holoceno en América del Sur. También se realizaron field trip. Ustedes saben que para analizar cuaternarios generalmente y más asociado a la geología hacemos mucho campo, entonces se hacían distintas reuniones y trabajos de campo como el que se realizó para analizar los LOES en Argentina. Perdón. Bueno, Martín Hiriondo llega a ser vicepresidente del INCUA y es por esto que Argentina ha estado muy involucrada en INCUA desde 1995 a 1999 y a partir de eso se generan un montón de comisiones y subcomisiones en donde también Argentina estuvo presente, no solo Hiriondo, sino otros investigadores que acompañaron estas formulaciones de propuesta. De hecho, en particular, Martín Hiriondo y otros investigadores fueron miembros de distintas comisiones de INCUA, como por ejemplo SATCOM o TEPRO, que son o están actualmente vigentes. Martín Hiriondo también fue parte, digamos, de la Comisión Internacional o el Consejo Internacional de INCUA y representó a este consejo en Estados Unidos y en Australia. Y también participó como comité editor en la revista del INCUA, el Cuaternario Internacional. Este pasado hizo que, bueno, que como desde que nacen los estudios del Cuaternario o se ponen en un ambiente de asociación, hasta la actualidad, digamos, pasamos del CADINCUA a la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario y Geomorfología en 1998. Esta asociación surge porque si bien existía el CADINCUA, hubo otro grupo de investigadores trabajando en Cuaternario que querían involucrar una asociación de estudios en geomorfología. Entonces, Rabassa fue uno de los investigadores que propuso unir ambas líneas, unir el cuaternario y unir la geomorfología, y a partir de 1998 se genera esta asociación. La importancia de la Asociación Argentina de Geomorfología y Cuaternario es la asociación que por estatuto elige al representante INCUA para que nos represente en las reuniones internacionales. Y es por esto que hemos estado representados entre el 2012 y el 2019 por Daniela Crodlin, luego fue postulada la doctora Alfonsina Tripaldi y actualmente yo fui propuesta como representante ante INCUA desde Argentina. Han habido, sin embargo, muchísimos investigadores, como les decía, que han trabajado en las distintas comisiones del INCUA y ha habido un diálogo muy abierto con INCUA, por lo cual Argentina es el único país en Sudamérica que está representado ante INCUA. Posiblemente esto se deba a que nuestra asociación se formó en 1980, o sea, lleva cierta trayectoria, pero por ejemplo, la asociación que agrupa los estudios del Cuaternario en Brasil se conformó en 1984 y ellos no han logrado tener un representante en INCUA. Eso no significa que a nivel personal o cada investigador no pueda participar de INCUA o no pueda participar en una comisión o en un proyecto, sino que los países dejan de tener la posibilidad de proponer nuevas temáticas o nuevas acciones o nuevas actividades. Igual nuestros colegas chilenos han recientemente formado el SOCHICUA, que es la Sociedad Chilena del Cuaternario, y ellos tampoco están involucrados, digamos, directamente con voz y votos en el INCUA. Lo que se ha hablado, lo que hemos hablado con la actual presidenta de INCUA, es tratar de ver si existiría la posibilidad de conformar un grupo sudamericano de cuaternario y poder de esta manera pagar una cuota común entre los tres o los cuatro países y se uniera Perú, ¿no?, con estudios de cuaternario. Pero en la región, en toda Sudamérica, los únicos que estamos con visión anti-INCUA, digamos, participando con representatividad es Argentina. Ay, perdón. Y finalmente me gustaría como invitarlos a formar parte de la comunidad de INCUA y también de la comunidad de la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario y Geomorfología. Actualmente somos unos 120 miembros, no todos activos, no todos están al día pagando su cuota, y esto es lo que más dificulta poder afrontar una cuota internacional con un valor en euros. Y también lo que tiene INCUA, perdón, lo que tiene la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario, es muy poca gente joven involucrada. Si bien las ramas o las disciplinas que abarca están asociadas tanto a geólogos, a geógrafos, a biólogos, a ingenieros y arqueólogos, hay muy poca gente joven que realmente participa de la Asociación Argentina de Cuaternario y Geomorfología, y mi mayor interés está en que se reúna o se junte gente para poder participar en esta asociación. Les dejo esa inquietud y bueno, cualquier pregunta estoy a disposición.
Muchas gracias, Estela, por tu presentación y por la invitación. Voy a introducir a Thais y después hacemos una sección de preguntas común, ¿te parece bien?
Sí, perfecto.
Bien. And it is an honor to introduce Dr. Thais van Colschoten, an emeritus, eminent figure with a distinguished academic and scientific career. Dr. Van Colschoten is an emeritus professor of paleoecology and quaternary biostratigraphy at the Faculty of Archaeology, Leiden University, the Netherlands, and professor at the East Institute of Cultural Heritage, Shandong University, Qingdao, China. He was INCUA's president from 2019 to 2023. And currently serves on the INCUA Executive Committee as past president. Dr. Van Colschoten has previously served as president of the INCUA Subcommission on European Stratigraphy and as a vice president of the INCUA Commission on Stratigraphy and Chronology. He is the founder of the European Quaternary Mammal Research Association, Euromam. He was the editor-in-chief of Quaternary International, the journal of the International Union for Quaternary Research from 2018 to 2021, and founding editor of the recently launched in 2023 INCUA Elsevier Journal, Quaternary Environments and Humans. Today, Dr. Van Colschoten will be speaking to us about INCUA and the INCUA Fellowship Program for International Mobility. I am also pleased to announce that we are joined by Dr. Aritina Haliuk. Dr. Haliuk is based in Romania. Her research is focused on paleoenvironmental studies, and currently she is the secretary of the INCUA. She will be available to kindly answer our questions. Her presence is a great opportunity to delve deeper into the discussed topics and address all the inquiries we may have. Welcome, Dr. Thais van Colschoten and Dr. Aritina Haliuk.
You. Okay, thank you very much. First of all, I would like to thank Macarena and also Stella for the invitation. I met Macarena in Chile at the PASES meeting, early career science meeting, which we jointly organized with PAGES and INCUA. We started that initiative in 2000. Oh, I think 16, 17, we thought it was nice to have a joint meeting. And the one in Chile was the second one. And I'm really very pleased to see there are so many young scientists, especially from South America also. And that's where I met Macarena. And it was very nice to be there. It was really a very inspiring meeting because meeting so many young people who are really inspired by the research they are doing and the way they presented their research and also the motivation to do the research. I really left Chile, actually, or South America, with a very positive feeling. I thought, okay, but this young generation, there is still really good, there is a good future, because you are very inspiring, very motivated, and very devoted, and you still believe in your research. And I was really impressed about it. And you can imagine how glad I was when I got an email from Macarena that she said she wanted to talk about Inqua and about being more involved in Inqua. And then we talked, and then she said, yes, maybe there are so a few more which are interested in hear more about Inqua. And then I suggested Macarena, I said, why don't you organize a meeting like this? And where you invite some of your colleagues, some of your friends also, but from Argentina, and I'm really surprised and honored that so many people turn up, hearing about what Inqua can do for you as researcher and what you can also do for Inqua on the other hand. And I'm happy to give a short presentation. Is partly maybe overlapping with what Stella was presenting, but it puts maybe the data in a little bit broader context. Anyhow, Stella, I really liked your presentation because also seeing all the people who are active in the past decades and like Oriondo, and I met them all, and it shows again the involvement of Argentina in INQUA, and it was really a pleasure to see them. Okay, but let's go on to the meeting of today. And what I will do, I will give a few slides on Inqua mission. I will tell you a little bit about the organization, the activities and the programs, and like our communication, international cooperation, and the participation of Argentinian quaternary scientists in Inqua. But then we focus on the current participation. And what is the future? Okay, so let's move on. Established in 1928, is a full member of the International Science Council. We have an INQUA Foundation, so we have the INQUA Association with the INQUA Foundation. I will say a few words on that later. And we are globally, and we have about 55 members, global members. The basic goal is actually to promote communication and international cooperation. So that is actually the focus of what we are doing. We want to support people to collaborate, and especially with aspects of quaternary research. And that quaternary research is of course about environmental changes. That's one of the topics which are of course very relevant in this aspect. This is how INQUA organizations is organized. And so there are a number of regional or country associations. So actually these are the countries which are they are represented by a delegate in the International Council. So this is the International Council is the body who is making decisions, and the INQUA executive. And this elected by the International Council, the INQUA executive prepares some decisions, come up with proposals. They have to be ratified by the International Council, but the International Council, by the in itself, has to be ratified by the General Assembly. The General Assembly is those people who are attending the INQUA Congress. So all the decisions made by the International Council have to be formally ratified by the General Assembly. This is a formality because the General Assembly meeting is at the end of the Congress. Everyone wants to go home, and they all support the International Council in that sense that they I never saw any disagreement with the decisions of the International Council. But the International Council is actually the deciding body in within INQUA. Then we have commissions, as Stella already said, and then we have also a number of working groups. These working groups are split off from the commissions recently, and they are now fall directly under the INQUA executive. Now, these are the membership. So in Europe, of course, many, but you see also in Africa, there are a few. There are a few in South America, and also in Asia, there are still many countries missing. As I said, we have also an Inqua Foundation that has to do with the fact that the Inqua Association was formally not registered until recently. They started in 1928, but formally they were not registered, and that has been done since about 2 years now that Inqua was formally registered. And the implication is also that we needed a financial responsibility is now in the foundation, whereas the association is closely linked with the foundation. The board of the foundation is also the board of the Inqua Association. But this is more a technical issue, but it was requested, or actually not only requested, that it was this was forced by several countries who only wanted to be member of an association which is formally registered and which has this structure. Okay, so this is the reason why we have this structure. As you see, the Inqua Executive since 2023, Laura Sadori is the president. Enrico Macchiarici is continued as Secretary General from 2019. She's already in place. Frank Buescher is the one who's also in Treasurer since 2000. He's Treasurer since 2017 already, so it's a long time. We have five vice presidents. Normally we have four: Maria Sansigoni, Pradeep from India, and Kathleen Nicole from America. Apart from that, also Aretina, who's really supporting this executive to do all the work they should do and sometimes don't do because of the lack of time. Speaking about the vacancy, we discussed it within the board, and one of the policies of the current board is that we want to have more influence, or we have more connection with the Global South, and so we more or less decided that we would like to have an extra vice president and a new vice president, if possible, from the Global South. And we had interviews with four people. And finally, we all agreed that Sebastian would be a great candidate to fill this position. An Argentine scientist, most of you probably will know him. He was an Inqua fellow last year, and since then I met him a few times. I met him also in Rome, and I was impressed about his attitude and about his knowledge, and we were very positive about it. And although the current status and bylaws of Inqua don't allow to have a vice president from a country he's not formally paying, we said, come on, let's forget statutes and bylaws. Our policy is more important than statutes and bylaws, and we really want to support this initiative, and we hope, and this is now up to the International Council to ratify our proposal, and that will run until the end of this week so far. So we'll have to wait until the end of the week, and then if at the end of the week, the situation as it is now, then we can remove these question marks and we can even put a name there. So that's great. We are very happy with this development. Commission presidents here, you see, commissions, coastal marine processes, human and biosphere, paleo climate commission, stratigraphy and chronology, and terrestrial processes, deposits and history. So these are the commissions, and then we have a group of early career scientists, and they form a separate community, and they're also represented in the board of INQUA and discuss with the executive about policy and about decisions, and involved in decisions we make about grant proposals and also all these kind of things. The chair of this ECI group is Sudhir from India. Okay, we have funding, and this is of course for you important. There are two categories of funding. There are two categories of grants. As I said, we try to promote international cooperation, and we we agreed that this can be done in, for instance, in establishing an international research network, and it can be multi-year, and it can be a single year. And multi-year means that you can apply for up to 4 years in a multi-year project. And if you realize that a normal grant application would go for about €8,000 roughly, then you, with a multi-year project, you can apply for about just over €30,000 to support your initiative. And a single-year project is now around €8,000. We also have special activities in the sense that we have what we call skill activities, where we train young scientists. If people come up with an initiative, for instance, to organize a summer school and to train some specific methods or specific skills, then you can apply for a grant to support your young scientists to come to these meetings. And again, this is about 8 to 10,000 euros. And then we have, of course, the INCRA Fellowship Program. And I will say a few words on that later. And then, of course, we also financially contribute to the INCRA Congress. Every 4 years, there's a big INCRA Congress. And normally we support these INCRA congresses with around 2,000 to 300,000 euros. In Rome, it was even more. And so it's a big amount of money goes to support young scientists to attend the congresses. Now, some INCRA projects. These are some of the INCRA projects in the past or in the current 5 years. At the moment, there are 18 projects are running and 20 are completed in this period. One of these projects is pSynthes, and it's a synthesis of databases of past human environment in the global south. One example, for instance, here SACOM has a big grant which is running also already for several years, and they have now a grant for another 4 years to create a database on terrestrial European key sites. EPALCOM is focusing on deglaciations. A very important and impressive project is Mapping Ancient Africa, Climate, Vegetation, Humans. Very, very productive project, which also has had a 4 year grant, and now we approved a continuation of another 4 years to continue that. Then, of course, the INCRA Fellowship Program. And the idea was, okay, if we want to support projects, we can support individual scientists to come to meetings, but maybe we can also support individual scientists more substantially by giving them financial support to go to another country, to go to another foreign institute for about a period of 3 to 6 months. This, of course, this whole idea about the fellowship program is not, it's not brand new. We looked and we did some brain picking at and looking at other associations, and I had meetings with SCAR, and SCAR also had fellowship programs, and I looked into that and thought this is an interesting way to do it. And now I talked with the people and how they organize it, and we thought, okay, maybe also as INCRA we should start doing that. We started the launched the program in 2022, and at that moment we we could support 14 scientists. You have to realize that the fellowship program is beneficial for the fellow, but also for the host, because they are going to a host institution, and also the host institutions, they have an advantage of having half a year a fellow who's producing now scientific results, publishing our scientific results. And so it's beneficial for both. And if we then look at the so in 2023 we had 14 fellows, and this year we have less because the amount of money is this year was not that as big as it was in 2023, and it has to do with the fact that during COVID we didn't spend all the money, and so we had some money left to support 14. This I think this is more reasonable that we will have about six in the future. And if you see that that's where they came from, now they came from also from Chile, Mexico, and Argentina. And so also South America is rather well represented in the in the home the origin of the home origin of the fellows. And if you see they at that period they mainly visit institutions in Europe. But this is not always the case. It can be also in other institutions, but we really want them to make use of the money to go really to go abroad and to go to good host institutions. And when is that in South America, it can also be supported. That's not the issue. So this is something we will continue to work on. And I must say that for this year we had 56 applications and we only chose six. So the competition is very high. In the first year it was about 50%, and now it's much the competition is much stronger. We hope to continue that in the sense that if we can show that we really have so much interest in having these fellowship programs, maybe we can also interest people, countries, or companies, or whatever to support financially the fellowship program from INCO also more in the future. But anyhow, we want to keep that going, and this is something we will will do. As I already mentioned, we have also allocated money for ICR workshops, jointly organized with PAGES and with IOBS, International Union of Biological Sciences. And the PAGES meeting, as I said, started in the first one was in 2018, and the second one was 2022, as far as I remember, finally took place in 2022 because of Corona, it had to be postponed. But we are, and the next one will be SOPQUA, will be in 2024 in India. So this is the next INCWA PAGES joint ECR workshop. So we want to have that meetings every second year, and INCWA as well as PAGES reserve money for supporting these meetings. So mainly meeting for, let's say, roughly about 50 early career scientists, which in a kind of workshop format with lectures by keynote speakers. And this one also will be online, will be hybrid. That means also that the keynote lectures and some of the other lectures can be followed via the internet. Recently, we also started a joint cooperation with the IOBS, the International Union of Biological Sciences, and we when I gave a presentation there about biodiversity in the past, they were very intrigued about the data INCWA has or a quarterly scientist has. And we were sitting together, and then we came up with the idea that we maybe should have a joint meeting, INCWA IOBS meeting, and then the focus is on changing in biodiversity and the evolution of present biomes. So looking at the present changes, but combine that with data from the past. And when I mentioned this to Macarena, she got excited. And so we already more or less have Macarena as representing the INCWA also already in the organizing committee, but we are still looking for more candidates to help us to organize the meeting. The meeting will take place in 2025, as it looks now in November 2025, and the meeting will take place in China. Those who are interested, follow the websites, follow the news, the monthly newsletter, and you can always contact Macarena if she and ask her if she knows more about it. Then we have, of course, as I said, the INCRA congresses. The first one was in 2000, 1928. The 20th was in 2019 in Dublin. Then we have, of course, the INCRA meeting in Rome. And then the next one will be in India in 2027. And that will be in February. And so they are working hard on the organization of the meeting. Then we have the INCRA Awards. So people can get an INCRA medal, Sir Nicholas Shackleton Medal for Outstanding Young Quaternary Scientist, the Li Tucheng Distinguished Career Medal for Distinguished Service for the International Community, and the Distinguished Service Medal for INCRA. These are the three medals. And the International Council members are asked to nominate people. And I think that there is really something where Argentina could play a role. And I really want to ask you to be more active in these kind of things. It can't be true that only good scientists, quaternary scientists, come from America. This is, of course, impossible. And so really, if you really try, look around and nominate your best colleagues, and to be part of this community, and nominate them, and finally we will select them. And I the number of nominations is really very limited, and that's a pity. And I think that is a possibility which you also as country should not lose. I can tell you, for instance, for the Li Tuncheng Distinguished Career Medal last year, we had only one candidate, which is, of course, not good. So please don't be too shy. Look around. Don't nominate yourself because that's not allowed, but ask your colleague to nominate you, and then and maybe you're then one of the candidates. Anyhow, so please keep this in mind and make use of this. This Nicholas Shackleton Medal will be awarded every 2 years, and the other two will be awarded every 4 years at the Congress. But this is also the mid-Congress. So by the end of this year, we will ask the International Council members again to nominate scientists, young scientists in this case, for the Nick Shackleton Medal. So please keep it in mind. INCRA publication is important to communicate with you. Of course, we had Quarterly Perspective. That was actually INCRA's newsletter every half a year. There was an INCRA newsletter about 36 pages every time there was an issue. And then in 2022, with the support of Aretino, we started the monthly newsletter, because one way or the other, we had the idea, we wanted to communicate with you as INCRA quaternary research community. And the way the communication was organized is that the board was collecting some news or some questions and so on, and we sent that to the International Council members and to the Commission presidents with a request to distribute it. But apparently they are also very busy, so altogether the distribution was a problem. And then we decided, okay, let's do it in another way. Let's start an INCRA a newsletter every month, and send it then via email to and it currently is sent to around 6,000 people, so they receive the INCRA newsletter to inform people about INCRA program, about the congresses, about grants, and so on. Since 1984, we have also the journal Quaternary International. It's an official journal of INCRA. Now it's a journal of jointly owned by Elsevier and by INCRA, and we publish 36 volumes a year, so that's three per month. And there were years, some years ago, we had up to 54 volumes a year. So it's really a very productive journal, with where a lot of quaternary scientists publish their papers. Recently, that means at the Congress in Rome, we launched a new journal, Quaternary Environment and Humans. And because we had a feeling that Quaternary International is very broad, but many of these papers which were submitted to Quaternary International were actually in the domain of geoarchaeology, bioarchaeology, material culture. And we could not publish all the papers, and so we thought this is a pity. And also, we wanted to create a platform for modeling studies, especially related to geoarchaeology, bioarchaeology, material culture studies. So we actually then created a journal which is based on these four pillars. Had a long discussion with Elsevier if they wanted to support it. They finally agreed. We found a chief editor, Andrea Saboni from Italy, and it's a full open access journal. It's an official journal again of the International Union of Quaternary Research of ICWA, together with jointly with Elsevier. And if you submit your manuscript this month, or probably also the coming few months, then the open access fee is waived until we have an the impact factor and officially accepted in Scopus. Until that time, there is either a reduction or a completely waived open access fee. So please make use of it. Look at the website. We have already many really very interesting and good papers. So we expect a lot from this new journal. Now, INCWA Communication, now the INCWA website, those who visited the website will be surprised, maybe because it's not a very good website. It's actually a drama, that website. Many links doesn't work anymore and so on. Much of the information is also outdated. We try to update at least the information on grant applications and so on. And we are working hard on the new website. We made a contract with a company 3 weeks ago. And next Thursday, Arantina and I and Kathleen and Frank will have the first kickoff meeting with the company. And this summer we will work hard on the new website. And after the summer, you will be surprised. And then you will see that there's really some improvement possible in the INCWA website. Well, embedded in the international organizations, in the International Council, we are a full member of the International Science Council. We're part of the ILUC unions. We have cooperation with the IOBS. We are affiliated with SCAR, the Arctic Research. Cooperation with PAGES. We have a strong connection with the Commission on Stratigraphy, and we participate in the Earth-Human Coalition. So in this way, also INCWA operates really on the international level. Now, Aretina was so kind to give a short overview about the participation of Argentinian quaternary scientists in INCWA, and we hope that Sebastian will be the new vice president. Now, this is only, of course, after next weekend, but don't worry. I think this is it will be okay. And then commission officers, Ignacio from Chile was in Polcom, and this year also we have some people from Argentina, but also from Chile and Mexico. And there's some projects. There is a Mexican project. It's maybe not completely Argentina, but at least you get a feeling also a little bit about how active South America is within INCWA. In 2020, visiting the Rome, we supported 12 ECRs to come to Rome from Argentina. The total amount supported was 27,000 euros, 6 to Argentina, 3 to Brazil, and 3 to Chile. And so it's in this aspect also showing that INCWA is really, for INCWA, it's important to have the links to also to Argentina and to show that also we try to support also you as community as good as possible. Now, yeah, and then of course it's Quaternary International. What this is what I wanted to show is that it's about submissions, support to the international. And of course, currently the most submissions come from China, and second is India, and then you have the United States, and then you go down to Germany, Poland, and so on. And here also, this is more or less the same field. The reason why I would like to show you this is also that we really would like to encourage you to publish in Quartern International. And so please prepare your manuscripts and think about that journal to publish it in that journal. Because by publishing in Quartern International, you really also financially support INQUA in a big way. Yeah? So if you think about the interest, the finances of INQUA, more than half comes from the connection we have with Elsevier. So more than half of the money is because of the production of the two journals, and less, far less, is from the member countries. And so by publishing in Quartern International in this way, also you already support INQUA in this way. And I think there are opportunities also for your community to play a role in this. Now, yeah, so what are the future challenges for us as INQUA executive? We want to have really more Quartern scientists involved from the Global South. And that started off already by having a vice president from the Global South. But also, we are now revising the editorial board of Quartern International. We're also revising the editorial team. And so the real editors of Quartern International, we're really looking for candidates from the Global South, from South America, and hence also from Argentina, to support INQUA at this level, to get more integrated. And also one of the things we need to do is to activate the INQUA Foundation. The INQUA Foundation is set up to not only to keep the money, but also we need to launch new funding options, and that makes the whole debate on whether a country can pay their fee or not less relevant, because we need to go to get our money from some other sources. And there are possibilities, I'm convinced, but it's a matter of creating this and activating the foundation. Now, major future activities, of course, you can imagine these are the big congress in India. But also, it's good to keep in mind that we have 1 year later, we have the INQUA Centennial Meeting. So it is 100 years INQUA. And we are thinking about, okay, what can we do? And one of the things is we should do something. We should use that opportunity to have meetings, maybe. Meetings in the different time zones during the year, and having maybe you can think of a 100-year INQUA meeting in Argentina, focusing on let's say South America, or only on Argentina, but give it a flag of 100-year INQUA, something like that. We need to think about it, and especially that overview Stella gave, starting with Darwin. It would be nice also to have a kind of, at that meeting, at the big INQUA Centennial Meeting, maybe it's good to have also a poster of now what was the history of quaternary research in Argentina in the past 100 years. Now there are all kind of possibilities. Think about it, and I'm sure we will come back to you and ask you to be involved. And this is, of course, also for the young scientists. Think about whether you can play a role in that, in these kind of meetings. And it's open. We are just starting to think about it. But this is one of the things I think we should use in the future also to say, okay, make use of that meeting. Try to get extra funds to support young scientists to come to those meetings, or whatever we can organize, can think of. Now, this is roughly what I wanted to say, and I want to thank you all for your attention, and there is time for discussions now. So please, if you have any questions, detailed questions, I directly pass on to Aretina, And but when it comes to policy also, and maybe Stella can answer some of the questions, and I try to answer some of the questions. So please feel free to ask questions, and if you have questions after the meeting is closed, don't hesitate to send an email to info.inqua.org, or that's Aretina, she will answer, or send it to me and we will come back to you and help you. Yes, okay, let's stop here, and maybe you have some information, you have some questions about grants and when the grant proposals have to be handed in and so on, and these exactly are questions Aretina can easily answer. Okay, questions.
Thank you so much, Dr. Yes, we have a couple of questions. Cynthia Robles asked that she wants to check if the grants are only for people from the careers naming at the beginning, or if someone who does not belong to them can access them.
I don't quite understand, because she's an early career scientist and she wants to know what are the restrictions for the application, or
Maybe she can give us an example. Cynthia, ¿nos podrías dar un ejemplo de qué a qué carrera te estarías refiriendo? Aritina is also active in the in the
yes,
chat.
I
Thank
have.
you. And give us a lot of links in order to start knowing about INCWA. Anyone have questions
Pienso
for
ahí,
Dr.
Macarena.
Moreiras?
Sí, pienso que
Yes.
lo que estaba preguntando, lo de las becas, el único limitante que hay es que tienen que abarcar o incluir estudios del cuaternario. Supongo ahí que estaba hablando de carreras. Dentro del INCUA no se hace diferenciación digamos, de las carreras. No hay, nadie se postula por carreras, sí por temáticas afines a cuaternario. Entonces, estadía, o no sé para qué está pidiendo o piensa postularse una beca, pero si la beca o la estadía que está pidiendo o el proyecto que está pidiendo involucra estudio del cuaternario, no la historia reciente, porque la historia reciente no entra dentro de, digamos, de lo que sería el Holoceno, debería ser más antiguo, por lo menos a 1000 años, podría, independientemente si es historia o geografía o la carrera que sea, lo importante es que esté estudiando en su beca o en su proyecto algo relacionado al cuaternario.
Perfecto. Andrea Coronato pregunta, can you detail a little more the procedures to ask for a 3 to 6 months foraging research experience? Thank you.
Okay, the fellowship program, we started that to support young scientists. So it is especially some young scientists like Sebastian, right? Young scientists who really want to do a real good research. And what we look at the importance of the research and how good is the candidate, when it comes to what previous research has been done, and of course also important is that they have apparently good contact with the host who's supporting that. So the whole procedure is that you come up with a research proposal, what you want to do at another institute, but you contact also the host so that the host is also supporting this application. So we get an application, which is written by the applicant, the fellow, supported by the host, who really support the application. And then we have also, I think, one or two reference letters of the supervisors in the country who have to say that it's really a good candidate, or I'm very happy that they leave the country and so on. So anyhow, all kind of things, information which can be used to for us to to judge. And based on that, we make a selection, and we try to make a selection and to be also inclusive when it comes to young scientists from different areas, but also women and men and so on. But also last year, we actually focused on the best applications, and then it turned out that they were from different countries, and that there was a good balance between females and males and so on. So that is, but application is that you are coming up with a proposal, show why you want to go to the host institution. That is very, sometimes it's because of equipment, sometimes it's because of the supervision, and then make clear why you want to go there, and you have to make also a financial overview up to 15,000 euros, how to spend the money, and based on that, we will finally make our decision. It's a
Perfecto,
matter also
guys.
looking at the website, and if it's not clear, please send us an email, and we can clarify all the questions you have.
Thank you, guys, for clarifying this point for us. There are any other questions?
I saw I see here a question to is it possible to apply to financial support for workshop if the topic is not related to one of the working groups? That's indeed also an interesting question, and indeed that is, because we look at the importance, and also how innovative it is and how important it is for INCWA. This year, for instance, we support a project, and Aretina, correct me if I'm wrong, but we support a project for a person to write a book for children about quaternary research. And we thought this is such a nice idea. This was not related to any working group. It's a new idea, and the way it was formulated, and the way it was presented, and that we really liked that proposal. And so it can be thinking out of the box. It can be a lot of things. It has not be to be related. The applications also, you can send in an application via one of the commissions, but you can also send in an application directly to INCWA, not having any commission involved, because we want to have also applications of fields which are not covered by the commissions. For instance, nowadays is a very strong development in biomolecular research in quaternary, and some people don't feel not supported by one of the commissions in this, so therefore they feel free also to send in the applications without involvement of the commissions. And last year, I think about half of the applications were without intervention of the commissions. So don't look too much at the working groups. Think about what you want, and think about especially. And that's maybe important to realize, that you want to have communication, you want to have networking. Don't ask for that you want to go on field work with two of your colleagues to Iceland and ask us to finance that. That's not what INCWA is financing. Nay, INCWA is financing interaction workshops and so on. But last year also, several applications were actually applications for supporting field work for a small group, and no international interaction, and so that's why we also renamed the funds to make it clear that this is about international networking. Other
Perfect.
questions?
Thank you so much. May the waived fee of the QHE be postponed? Is
Yes, it looks
Maria
like that.
Montini asking?
Yeah, important is formally is formally we said first until the end of June. Now next Friday we have a meeting again with Elsevier discussing how to if we can postpone it, and if you really have a good manuscript waiting or almost ready, contact the editor in chief, announce it, and we will take care of it. And it's still not too late to get either a very high reduction or get the open access fee waived. So I think this is the situation. But don't wait until next year, because then it will be more difficult.
Okay.
Although I must say also we have an agreement with Elsevier that they sponsor five open access fees from scientists from South America. So it's also in this aspect there are still some options available.
Great. Anyone have more questions? Here I have one. I would like to consult in reference to financing research projects that allow the development of files, tasks, and laboratory analysis, specifically in the field of archaeology.
Yeah, that's also. I know this feeling or the wish to get support for these kind of for analyses and so on. And in the past, sometimes we financed this, but now the competition between the applications is so big. Also, the project applications this year, we have 57. And finally, we only supported 15. So that means that these kind of applications very quickly drop out, because it's not really what we say this is international networking, and since the money is limited, we decided not to support these kind of things.
Great, thank you so much. Anyone have more questions? You can speak too.
I just want to make a comment.
Hola, Sebastián.
Hola, Estela. Hola, Macarena. Hi, Thys and Regina. I didn't expect any announcement today. So it's quite a surprise, because I didn't say too much here in Argentina, just with a few colleagues. In the last month, I was waiting the official announcement of INCWA, but it's an honor to work in the executive committee, and mainly in all the things that we have been discussing in this meeting today. Mm-hmm. About the connection between Latin American researchers with more involved in INCWA, and especially with the early career researchers to apply to all of these INCWA tools for especially it is important to remark that the idea of INCWA is the international collaboration. So any idea, any project that involves the participation of Latin American, in this case, in our case, researchers with highly specific or qualified research groups, especially in Europe and the North America is most commonly, is what Inqua most hope for the project that for applications. That's all. Just to say hello and thank you for the introduction in this.
Yeah, Sebastian, by the fact that you say that you didn't expect it, then I thought about it and maybe thought, okay, maybe I made a big mistake by announcing it. But I'm so excited about the idea that you will join us that anyhow, I really hope that this will not result in a formal disagreement or whatever. This is more that anyhow. So for also for those who are still there, please keep it quiet until the end of the week. And but anyhow, I'm really very pleased, Sebastian, that you join us. And because I think this is really a major step in the direction of having more involvement. And also, I really hope that this is also the beginning of a process in which finally we will have a big Ingwa Congress in South America. This is also something which we have to keep in mind. I think the community is big enough, and there are several young people like Macarena who really have the energy and motivation, but especially also the vision to make something out of it. So this is something which we you have to build it up for many years, and that's why I think this could be a real good start in having these closer connections with you as community, and then think about it. And I'm really also very happy that Macarena is involved in the meeting with the IOBS. And so we have to start creating more of this close cooperation. And I really would like to encourage also you as Argentinian scientists, quaternary scientists, to take a role in the organization. And but also, as I said, nominate people for the awards and make use of INCWA in that sense. Make use of sending in applications for projects which you can get financed. If you look at the Now, where the projects are dominated, or for instance, also if you look at the commission presidents currently, it's all male, and they are from Europe, and this is not what we're looking for. We need to be global, and I think you have to encourage your community to take that role, and it's a matter of and if you take the role, INCWA supports you financially also to play that role. It's not a matter of if you're off the board, then you have to pay to travel to organize. INCWA is supporting these kind of things, and of course you have to do some work for it, and you have to you have sometimes meetings, but it's important also to get your ideas involved in the development of INCWA. And one of the big challenges for INCWA is how to get the community of the Global South more involved in all kind of issues, because many issues about biodiversity and so on are also on the Global South. So one way or the other, we need to have the conversation with each other, and INCWA wants to play a role in it, and it can be done on the level of publications, can be done on the level of meetings, and but also on the level of integration of young scientists to be take a role in it. So
Thank you so much.
I'm very excited about so many people who are attending the meeting, and yes, I hope
50 now.
that it will be. I really like these kind of initiatives, and because I think this is the way to do it, and to have some conversation with a group like this is really great. So
Well, Mariana Mondini say, as the current president of the International Council of Archaeology, I am sure we can certainly collaborate more tiny in the future. Thank you so much, Mariana. And we have more
One more question, I think. Can we apply as an undergraduate student for the grant, I suppose?
No.
Not as undergraduate students, no. But it's a matter of being
Okay.
creative. Find another student who has a PhD and try to cooperate and come up with the ideas. It's a matter of there is room for creative solutions in these kind of things.
Anyone have more questions? Here, Aritina, give us the link for the application procedures and yes, application and more links are all in the chat.
Yeah, there is the link
Link.
for the fellowship application, and there is also the link for project application. And I also have there the link to subscribe to our monthly newsletter and our email in case you have any questions or anything. Just drop us an email and there will be someone answering.
Perfect, thank you so much. If this
Also, sorry, Macarena, also all the information about this grant are in the web page of the Association of Quaternary and Hemorphology of Argentina. So if someone needs more information, they can find in Spanish and they or could send the link of the INQUA.
perfect. Thank you so much. Well, if
Okay.
anyone have any questions?
Last sentence from my side. As I said, we're working on a new website. That means also that as soon as the website, the structure and the framework is ready, we will ask also different groups to send us attractive information, video clips, whatever. I looked at your website. I really like it, although there are still some links which don't work. But anyhow, there's something where I would say we will ask for that. So be aware of that. You can use also the INQUA website in the future to promote your own association and so on. So also we will ask you to contribute also to the new INQUA website.
Right.
Thank you.
Well, if anyone have more questions, it was an honor for me to join you. I present Dr. Moreira, Dr. Van Potschoten, and Dr. Haluk. We will keep in touch, and thank you so much to all of you for being here.
Thank
Macarena,
you.
only a detail.
Yeah.
The presentation are going to be in YouTube. Someone want
Okay.
to see
I
again,
forgot.
yes, in the Janigla website.
Okay. Maybe you can
Great.
wait to put it on the website after the 1st of July, because otherwise the whole world will know that Sebastian. No, I don't think it's very important. But anyhow, think about it.
Just a couple of days.
Okay. Thank you very, very much all. It was a pleasure for me and an honor to speak to you. And as I said, if you have any questions, please contact us. We're there to support you and to help you. Yes?
Thank you
Okay.
so much.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Everyone.
Thank you.